Hello students, today we discuss on the second type of FBC, that is the pressurized FBC, pressurized fluidized bed combustion boiler. So this is the schematic representation of pressurized fluidized bed combustion boiler. So the difference between the pressurized fluidized bed combustion and the circulating fluidized bed combustion is, in circulating fluidized bed the operation is done on the atmospheric pressure, and here in the PFBC the pressure of air, or the air which is supplied under the pressure, is the 10 bar pressure. So for that purpose we use the compressor which compresses the air at 10 bar and then send towards the again the combustion chamber. So now we discuss on the pressurized fluidized bed combustion boiler. So it is very similar to the circulating fluidized. This section here is the distribution plates are there, from here the water is inserted inside the tubes and steam goes out in this section. So when the bed becomes fluidized, the heat is exchanges, and then the flue gases and the unburned particles of the carbon or the flue gases or the fuel is goes towards in this way, and then it is collected in the cyclone collector. It is collected in cyclone collector, and the unburned carbon or the unburned combustible particle is then again sent towards the combustion chamber in this way. Means what? Here on distribution plates the fluid becomes fluidized, then it exchanges the heat, and then the remaining flue gases and the particles, unburned particles, are collected here and again transported towards the combustion chamber. This one cycle is completed. In the other way, the flue gases forwarded and clean here and then forwarded towards the dust collector, and from the dust collector it goes towards the gas turbine. Means what? The clean flue gases is transported towards the gas turbine here. With the help of that flue gases the gas turbine is run, and the shaft of compressor is coupled to the gas turbine. So the gas turbine runs the compressor, and then at this moment the compressor works with the help of gas turbine, and it compresses the air, and then the compressed air of 10 bar at a pressure of 10 bar is sent towards the combustion chamber in this way. Here the compressed air goes in this way and sent towards the fluidized bed combustion boiler here. So in this section the dust is collected, and then the dust and the remaining ashes goes towards the exhaust. Here the first ash or the initial ash from here is collected here and then sent towards in this way, and the secondary, the whatever the ashes in the flue gases, is collected here, and with the help of centrifugal action it is transported towards the exhaust in this way here. And then at very initially the fuel enters here from this hopper, like coal and limestone, mixture of coal and limestone is inserted here, and then that fuel is sending to in this way towards the combustion chamber or the fluidized bed over the distribution plates here. Okay, so I will repeat it again. So from this section the mixture of coal and limestone is inserted here, sent towards the fluidized bed or the distribution plates. From this way the air is supplied under pressure of 10 bar approximately with the help of air compressor driven by a gas turbine. So it is sending towards the on the distribution plates, and then the bed become fluidized, and the flue gases and the unburned carbon goes in this way. So the particles, unburned particles, are trapped here, and then they are recirculated towards the again combustion chamber, and then the remaining flue gases goes towards the gas turbine. Here again the dust is collected, dust and ash, and that dust and collected ash is sent towards the exhaust. And now the remaining flue gases, cleaned gases, are run the gas turbine here and then goes to the exhaust, and then with the help of gas turbine driven by the flue gases drive the compressor, and then compressor compresses the air at a pressure of 10 bar, and then that air is sent towards again the combustion chamber. So in this way, the pressurized FBC works. Now, what are the advantages of FBC? The advantages of pressurized FBC is like high steam generation rate, low NOx means what? Low emission of nitrogen oxide, low formation of sulfur dioxide, that is SO2. The cost of plant is reduced, and require the reduced air velocity as compared to the circulating FBC. And the disadvantage of this type of boiler is the life of plant is low as compared to the other boilers. Means what? The life of this plant is as compared to less, and the complexity of the operation in the pressurized fluidized bed combustion is more. Means what? Complexity is maximum in the operation. So these are the disadvantages of the pressurized FBC boiler. Now we concentrate on the general arrangements of FBC boiler. So it consists of following systems. That is, first one is a fuel feeding system. In fuel feeding system, it is again divided into two, that is underbed pneumatic feeding and overbed feeding. Then second system is a air distributor system. Third one is a bed heat transfer system and in-bed heat transfer system. Means what? In this system there are two subsystem, bed heat transfer and in-bed heat transfer. Then next is a ash handling system. It is again divided into two, that is first is a bottom ash removal and then second is a fly ash removal. So now first is a fuel feeding system. In fuel feeding system, the first one is a underbed pneumatic feeding. In it, the coal crushed at a size of 1 to 6 mm size and pneumatically transported from the feed hopper. And in second one, that is overbed feeding, it accepts the oversized fuel and also eliminates the transport line as compared to the underbed feeding. And it is also accepted, the size of coal is 6 to 10 mm. Now next is a air distributor. The purpose of distributor is to introduce the fluidizing air evenly through the bed cross section for keeping the solid particles in a constant motion and also preventing the formation of defluidization zones within the bed. That is the purpose of the air distributor. Then next is a bed and in-bed transfer surfaces. So first one is a bed heat transfer surface. In it, the bed material of 1 mm size of limestone or sand or ash is used, and again it is in two types it is divided, that is first is a shallow bed and second is a deep bed. In shallow bed, it offers a lower bed resistance, so the lower pressure drop and lower power consumption is done, and in deep bed pressure drop is more, which is increase the effective gas velocity and the fan power. Now secondary is a in-bed heat transfer surface. Here it's necessary to transfer the heat between the bed material and the immersed surfaces. So the heat exchanger will be maybe horizontal or vertical or inclined. Then next is a ash handling system. In ash handling, the first one is a bottom ash removal. That 40% of total ash is removed with the help of or in the bottom ash removal system. And the remaining one is a fly ash system. The amount of fly ash to be handled in FBC boiler is relatively high. So as compared to conventional boiler, this is due to the separation of particle according to the size and the shape at the high velocity. And it is fly ash should be removed in three stages. First is in a convection section, then secondary from the bottom of the air preheater. And finally, a major portion is removed in the dust collector. So in this way, the fly ash should be removed. So this is the general arrangement system of the FBC boiler.